and welcome to Fact or Fiction, a show where we discuss what made the news this week and whether it was real or not. I'm Suyash Barve, and with me is Jensi Jacob from Boom. Jensi, a busy week of fact-checking.
Yes, hi Suyash. And it's a really cracking week because a lot of stories and a fun episode ahead.
Alright, let's jump right in. This week we're starting a story that has us scratching our heads. Primarily because we work in Mumbai, where it takes us at least 20 minutes just to go across the street.
That's true.
But apparently up north, you can get from Srinagar to Leh in 15 minutes flat. Jensi, a tad absurd, no?
Yes, definitely absurd, but to give the benefit of doubt to Smriti Irani, the union minister who actually retweeted this Times of India story, probably she didn't notice it, you know, that's at the end of the day, it was not her fault, it was not her line. But the context to this is that the cabinet a few days back had approved the building of a tunnel on the Zojila Pass, where it actually takes 3.5 hours to just cross that that area.
Right.
And this work that they are going to do now, that's going to take about 7 years at a cost of 6,000 crores, is going to reduce that 3.5 hours to 15 minutes. Now, Smriti Irani retweeted this through the Narendra Modi app, NM app, as we can see on the Twitter feed as well. And she did not notice it. Now, people trolled her, reminding her it takes about 18 to 21 hours. And also, many of them said that, yes, you did retweet, but didn't you notice? Because at the end of the day, you were part of that cabinet.
She's kind of involved in the process of this. You should have known the details.
You would, at least it should have come to your mind. Times of India also noted it and they put out a correction later on. Now, very interestingly, now here's the really interesting part. She went on Instagram, where she's actually very active as well. And she put out an image, as you can see it on the screen, it's self-explanatory, and said, "Your opinion is duly noted." So, yeah. You know, that's the kind of spirit that she has. She will not back down, she'll not delete the tweet, and she'll hit you back with another image.
I truly start to worry when cabinet ministers get information that they were involved in to begin with from newspapers. This story is a gross exaggeration and false. Let's jump ahead now to the fake news brigade's most hated nation, Pakistan. This past week, a story popped up that claimed a Hindu family in Pakistan was attacked for hoisting a saffron flag at their home. Any truth to this at all, Jensi?
Definitely not. In fact, this is quite an old video a few years back where this was shot in Pakistan, where some of these protesters in Faisalabad, they had come out on the streets because there were like 18 to 20 hours of power cuts. And they were protesting and they attacked a power station nearby. And what we saw here is the police actually, they got out of hand. There was a police excess here because they really went out and started searching for the demonstrators and, you know, went into their houses. They beat up the woman as well. That's the whole context to this. But after some years, people have now discovered this video and they have figured out, let's play some mischief with this. And they are saying that this is actually a Hindu family in Pakistan,
right,
who had a saffron flag on the top of their house, and that's the reason why they are being beaten up. The context also that they're trying to give is that in India, Muslims can actually fly the Pakistani flag and get away with it, but you know, look at a Hindu family, how they are being persecuted in Pakistan.
Yeah, that's the worrying quote for me from that story, is that Muslims in India fly the Pakistani flag. That's untrue.
I mean,
there may have been instances of the Pakistani flag flying in India,
yeah,
but for the most part, what you're actually seeing is the Islamic flag. What we're going to show you on screen here, the differences between the two. Jensi, would you care to explain the differences between the two flags and why there's such a confusion over this?
So if you look at the Pakistani flag, there is a white vertical band, and then you have a dark green, and then there is a crescent and a star. But you also see a lot of Muslims actually using, you know, whenever there's a rally or something, you see another flag which is quite similar looking, which probably adds to the confusion. Where you have a green flag and there's a background is green, and then you have a crescent and a star. But that's where people fail to notice that the Pakistani flag has a white vertical band. You know?
And a slightly different shade
And it's a slighter shade as far as the Islamic flag is concerned.
I mean, it's the flag of Islam. It is not the flag of Pakistan. So this story, on more than one count, is false. Now let's move on to our next story. What we're about to see is a video tweeted out by Dr. Gaurav Pradhan, a Twitter handle with a reasonable following. Let's check out this video.
Come on, yalla chaniya.
Takbir!
Allahu Akbar! Yalla, yalla! 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 Aisha, 18 years old, she's been used before. sell them very cheap. I sell this now. $25. $25 for a Christian cup. Just, she's committed to Allah. $50. Would anybody else like Aisha? Yalla Aisha, yalla.
Jency, what's the story here?
So here we see this handle, Dr. G. Pradhan, has over 1 lakh followers.
Yeah, reasonable following. Yeah.
Reasonable, and is an influencer, and has been actually called out many times in the past as well to, you know, building this narrative about Islam and about, you know, as far as, you know, the very favorite narrative of many of these handles. Now, he has put out this video where you can see some men actually dragging women who are completely chained, and a kind of a slave auction that is happening, you know, on the streets in London. Now, he put this video out without giving the context of it, and actually said, you know, oh, this is how this place is also going to, this country is also going to turn into Syria very soon,
right,
because of ISIS. Now, we've called him out, and many several others also have pointed it out to him. Now, the context here is that in 2014, BBC has put out a story that there is this organization, this NGO called Compassion for Kurdistan, you know, and these are Kurdish activists who were protesting how there is not much global attention being paid to the fact that ISIS is, you know, the amount of damage they are doing there, and the way they are, you know, putting so much of pressure on women, you know, bring them as slaves and selling them as slaves and the entire slave trade. So to depict that and to also create a lot of awareness, they did this mock auction on the streets there. And that's why this video became viral. And I was just checking YouTube also. It has been seen over 2.5 lakh times since right. 2014. Now, without giving a context to that, you know, someone here in India decides to put it out and again, you know, build this narrative. You know, see, this is the reason why we are calling this video out again and again, because give the context to the video, leave it for people who see it to make their own decisions and understand how it is. But don't put out a video without giving the context of what it is.
So basically a protest against ISIS is completely misconstrued and
yes.
taken the entirely the other way.
Right.
That video is 100% false. Of course, we can't possibly finish an episode without busting a video about new currency. Here's a video that was widely shared across WhatsApp and social media. Jency, kill the suspense for all of us. Fact or fake?
So several people tagged us on this video and they asked us, you know, you can see in the video that there is this man actually stacking up several currency notes. You know, it's, you know, there's something about currency notes and the way stacked.
Yeah, it just,
you know,
drives the imagination wild.
Yeah, it drives your imagination wild, and you wonder, you know, can you have a hand over that one of those bundles, you know? So that's the reason why this video is going viral, because you see, when you see closely, these are 50 and 200 rupee notes. So these are not old notes, you know, so these are very new notes, and very clearly these are not RBI's printing press. You can make out that this is something which is not right,
yeah.
something not legal, or we don't know what it is. Interestingly, when you actually zoom in into one of the notes as we did, we found out that there it is written, instead of Bharatiya Reserve Bank, it is Bharatiya Children's Bank.
A note and a currency and a bank that we've heard of before on
yes,
this show.
And,
yes,
and that's what we pointed out to people as well, saying that, no, please zoom in and you will get to know that these are not original notes, these are fake notes. But let me give also, you know, give an idea of this has happened in the past as well. In February 2017, when there were some of these notes with, you know, Children's Bank of India, which were found in an SBI ATM in New Delhi.
Right.
So that's the reason why several people are saying that, oh, you are saying that it is some Bharatiya Children's Bank and these are not even original notes, closer to the original notes. But, you know, there has been a context, this has been found in an SBI ATM in the past.
Right.
We can't make out. Several people on Facebook and various other mediums are saying that this has happened in Bangladesh. But unfortunately, we have not been able to confirm that. There are no confirmation to say that this has happened in Bangladesh.
Right, Gen Z, I think you're a total buzzkill. Refuses to believe in fun currency and refuses to believe in the children's bank. I feel bad for you. I think the children's bank is the new Bitcoin. Alright, that wraps it up for this week. You can find each of the stories we've covered today on boomlife.in. You already know where to follow us. You can also subscribe to our Boom Life broadcast by WhatsApping us on this number. You can also use that number to WhatsApp us a story that looks dubious or you think might be fake, so we can tell you whether it's fact or fiction. Thanks so much for joining us this week. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.